Hello, Malty Morrisons. Ralphie here. And thank you to Chaz Rolas for the malt mention. The Morrisons, by the way, is Jim Morrison's from The Doors. A few of you musos will understand what all that's about. It's a little bit about music antiquity, recent antiquity. But talking of antiquities, here's a genuine antiquity. Now, this rather heavy piece of iron and nickel that I'm holding in my hand is a meteorite. And it was once, many, many thousands of years ago, part of a meteor which entered Earth's atmosphere. It was very large, it weighed in excess of 60 tons, and it broke up due to the intense atmospheric pressure created by the gases round surrounding planet Earth, the oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen and other gases. It became subject to quite violent shock waves due to the atmospheric pressures, and it broke up. And when it landed on the planet in the north central region of Argentina, approximately 7,000 years ago, it broke into thousands of pieces. It is a Campo de Cielo meteorite. And it's quite heavy, so I'm going to put it back in its stand. I bought this on eBay. I did my research to make sure it was genuine, because you can buy fake meteorites if you're not careful, because they do generally command very high prices depending on the rarity. This is not a rare meteorite. This is one of the most common meteorites to be found, because there's over 60 tons of it came into this planet's atmosphere, and being primarily a metal meteorite, specifically it was an iron octahedrite, that's a scientific name for it, meteorite. It remained remarkably intact. Some meteorites are vaporized completely in the Earth's atmosphere, particularly stone meteorites, which are simply more fragile and susceptible to destruction when they're flying at high speed through the air. When meteorites enter Earth's atmosphere, they heat up until they are literally glowing hot, white hot metal, sending off sparks. And if you're ever fortunate to see a meteorite, a meteor flying through Earth's atmosphere, you're seeing one of the great wonders of Mother Nature. And I bought this, cost me I think about several hundred pounds actually, which is quite a lot of money, but bear in mind, it is an authentic, tangible and very fascinating part of the natural world, which it's a joy to own something that you hold in your hands, knowing that it's 4,600 million years old. It's older than this planet. It has travelled from somewhere in the universe, possibly, yeah, billions of years, in the vacuums of space. Goodness knows what this little lump of iron nickel has seen in its journeys, the stars, the planets, the comets, other meteors, the gas clouds, and perhaps even a few spaceships. But it is an extraordinary and beautiful thing. You know it's genuine because you can see the flow lines when the metal was heated to a plastic state. And you can also, when you use a magnifying glass, and a very strong one, you can see the little tiny specks of emerald which have crystallized on the surface of this piece of ore, I think you could call it. I don't suppose that's not a very technical term, on this piece of metal, this lump of metal. I find this far more interesting than bot art, man-made stuff. I think some of the finest sculptures never see the hand of men or women, but are best when left to the greater wisdom of nature. Just saying. And I used this as my inspiration, maltmates, for a bottle of whiskey, which I'm going to introduce to you and tell you all about. It's quite unique. It's a bit like this meteorite. There's not a lot of it, and it's really quite singular. Here it is. The inaugural commercial bottle of Ralphie.com single malt whiskey. As you would expect from a Ralphie.com, it is unchill filtered, it is colouring free, it has an age statement of 12 years, it has a cask number because this is a single cask Port Charlotte, bottled at a cask strength of 56.2%. And this looks remarkably the same natural colour as this, because this was the bottle that I got bottled by Bruichladdy Distillery from a cask of Port Charlotte, which I bought in 2004 when I was at the Bruichladdy Academy. And it turned out to be an absolute belter of a cask. I'm not going to do tasting notes for you because coming from me, they are inevitably going to be biased. But what I will tell you is, when I had three of these bottles on the Bruichladdy's table at the Glasgow's Whisky Festival in November 2016, the bottles, after a few hours, were entirely emptied. Such was the popularity with which the drams were received. And I donated three bottles to Bruichladdy as a thank you for bottling this version quickly for me, to celebrate my world land speed record on the Bonneville Salt Flats in 2016. So it was 74.7 miles per hour. So I had 74.7 bottles bottled from my cask. However, this has never been for sale commercially. There's only one went up for sale, and that was at auction not so long ago to raise money for a local charity, and it did very well indeed. This was bottled as a reward for sponsors and a thank you for friends who supported me on my mission. But what do you do with the rest of the cask? You can't leave it too long, because do you know what? These angels, they're still looking for their share, and when they see the barrel going down, they want even more. So I didn't leave it too long before bottling the rest of the cask, from which I got 233 bottles. Now, it doesn't matter how good a whisky is. You're never going to get through 233 bottles. After the first dozen, you're going to get over familiar with it. So I thought to myself, well, I may as well be resourceful, sell the whisky, and use the money for another project, another whisky-related project, which is in the planning stage at the moment. So with only being one cask and only 233 bottles, to keep things practical and simple, this bottle has been put on sale in only one whisky shop, which is in Glasgow, in Bath Street, and it's got called the Good Spirits Company.com. www.goodspiritsco.com. And I will provide a link in the description box below to the website. There's not a lot of bottles. It has been selling over the last few days quite vigorously because it's so singular and unique. It's not just the fact that it is generally agreed that it's a really good single malt and probably one of the most phenolic and earthy versions of Port Charlotte out there, but I've made sure that as a Ralphie.com inaugural bottling, it has features that you will not find on any other bottle of whiskey ever. The main feature is the seal. The seal is vinyl and holographed. It's a security seal. It has got little cuts in it to make it even more tamper-proof than normal. It is the largest holographic seal that I am aware of that has ever been put on a bottle of whiskey. And furthermore, the number on the seal matches the number on the label because the label is individually numbered. Every seal is hand-signed by myself. And there are 5 layers of security relating to this bottle of whiskey, which I shall not discuss, but they're there. And in my opinion, it makes this probably one of the most secure and complex for fakers to reproduce. Fake whiskies are increasingly a big issue, and anyone who is a collector of unusual quality single malt whiskies, I am confident, will find this feature very appealing. These labels were specially commissioned exclusively for Ralphie.com bottlings. £120 a bottle, that's expensive. I originally was going to charge a bit less, but my friends in the business recommended this price simply to discourage speculators. If you're interested in buying a bottle, it is certainly something which is tangibly unique. I may do a bottling of one cask once a year. That's the limit of my ambitions with whiskey. And if you are buying a bottle, if it does appeal to you, I would look into it sooner rather than later because there's only 233 bottles and they're selling quite fast. Be aware, wherever you are in the world, be conscious, if you're thinking of buying, how much it will cost to post the bottle to you. Postage costs for bottles of whiskey, in my opinion, are a rip-off. However, the options to postage are very restricted, unless you know someone who can collect on your behalf, which is the ideal situation, or whether you choose to buy and have stored in the place where you buy it for another day. That's another option, if you can arrange that. But really, postage is not so expensive from Scotland to Europe, but from Scotland to the United States of America, it's ultra expensive. American postage is surprisingly expensive, even buying stuff from America. For postage to Scotland is incredibly expensive for what you're getting. Just sharing that with you, malt mates, so as you know. The meteorite has been put on the picture and the label, and you'll notice how beautifully colour coordinated the tartan background is with my jacket, because the colour of the tartan background tells you what year the whiskey was bottled, if you're a fan of Ralphie. See the little details? The message on the bottle says, "The iron octahedrite meteorite is 4,600 million years old. This malt is 12 years old. Both are interesting. And they are. In fact, to be honest, this tastes a bit like this looks. All the important details: Port Charlotte, sherry hogshead, cask number, unchill filtered, colouring free, age statement, cask strength specified. Frankly, it's the only thing that you would expect from an Alfie.com bottling, is to practice what I preach. I hope you find this of interest, maltmates. If you want to follow up on if you happen to be a whiskey collector or a whiskey fan with a bigger budget than average, good luck. I would email the Good Spirits Company or phone them, and bearing in mind the time zone differences, as soon as possible, because, as I'm saying, it's just recently gone on sale and it's selling fast. Good luck. Thank you for watching. I'm leaving this video on YouTube permanently. Do you know why? Do you know why I'm not going to remove this? Because it now becomes part of the perpetual provenance relating to this bottle of whiskey, of which there is no tangible equal of any other whiskey ever bottled out there. More uniqueness. Thanks for watching. I'm Ralphie. I'll be back soon with some rum reviews. It's a while since I've been tackling rum. Things are getting really, really interesting with rum, you know. Very interesting indeed. I shall be sharing with you. Bye-bye.